Welcome to my channel, Fat Dandy Lines. My name is Mona Lee, and I don't want to make a part 5. So let's finish this all up. So this is the front folder. I have the smaller bits of cards or pictures, and there's an envelope in here. I'm gonna put it in here. And of course, I didn't show you that I've stamped on it. And after stamping, you can use the wet cloth, like baby towel, that you can throw away afterwards, or the one with when you clean up with also with a moist towel. That is, let's see, sold in like these packages like this. So this is cleaning wet towels. This is lemon fragrance. So I use that to clean it up. You cannot use stamps and then, well, finish stamping and just throw it in the bin, because then this ink will touch everything that's in the box, and that's not very ideal. So that's why you have to always clean up the stamps, so you can, with content heart, you know that that you have cleaned the stamp up and you've put it away nicely. So that's the thing. So I've stamped on this folder. I'm gonna put it inside this pocket like this. And this part without the folders, let's see if I can use all of these inside this folder like this, and put it in this pocket. Can I put it in? Yes, I can put it in. And then this part, I'm gonna put it into the pocket itself. So I turn the paper bag around. As you can see, I'm gonna put it inside the loaded paper bag. So I have not decorated this part, and that's why it's vital that this picture that of the sliced banana, I want to use it in here. But I want to also put another piece of washi tape. Apparently the ink smudged my paper, so I'm gonna put a piece of washi tape on like that. Cut it here. And the paper, this, I can glue it onto here. So then is this little space free or open to put the name of the recipient of this snail mail. So then it's done. And I thought by myself, this is empty in the sides. So I thought by myself, maybe I can just use the stickers of the banana like so. I don't have the Chiquita banana stickers, but I have the Del Monte one. So I'm gonna put it like on the sides. Do another one. Maybe next time, if I find the Chiquita banana stickers, I use it for another time. So there is this another one. And stick it onto the fold, so you cannot see the fold anymore. I'm gonna take the stickers out. Because in the corner, if you can see it, there is a package there, and I received a package today from AliExpress. Like this. So in case the sticker still flies out of the paper, just fortify it with some glue. So it won't come out. So I can still, if I want, I can still write here more goodies or something like that. Or I don't know, whatever. So then if I have done the other things, like the personal letter, a paper of questions and answers, a paper of favorite things and other things, maybe some die cuts, more stickers, washi tape samples, then I can close it by folding it how many pleats I want or how many folds I want, and then put pressure on this part and rub it with my nails, and then put a nice sticker on here, and then I'm done. I'll need to find a suitable envelope to put this loaded paper bag inside the envelope, and that envelope I need also to decorate. But I just want to finish today and want to eat my banana and open my mail. So I'm going to take this little piece of double-sided tape and stick it somewhere on the side. Oh! It was not supposed to stick on that place. So I'm going to, like I said, eat my banana off camera while you still can hear me chew, chew, chew and swallow. So, in the meantime, I'm going to clean up. I'm not eat the skin of the banana. I just threw it away in the bin. So I'm gonna put these aside. I am curious. I don't know exactly anymore what I ordered at AliExpress, so I don't know what I've here inside the bag. It says cut die. So I'm gonna cut it open. Let's see. Where is the best spot to open it? Like I said, I don't know what's inside. Just open it with scissors. Wow, that's ridiculous. I don't know if you can see it. Here's my desk light. So I've put my envelope in front of it. And I see this little bit for such a big envelope. I don't understand. Why do they do that? Oh, it's for Alina Craft. That's right. Alina Craft always like to use bigger envelopes. I don't know why. Okay. Maybe they are afraid that it's gonna be lost in the mail. I can't open it, you know what? I'm gonna cut it with scissors. Oh, yes, it's umbrella and rain boots. Nice. And some butterflies. So this is an empty envelope because I took the the dice out. Some more. I'm gonna cut open the... No, maybe I can rip it open. No. Sorry. The banana is too sweet. I need to chase it away with some water. Tea. Oh, stickers of Star Wars. Nice. Nice. This is the Lucky Cat dice. I have two sizes, a smaller version and a bit bigger. Let's see. Oh, look. I have three kinds of other Maneko Neki cats, Lucky Cat dice. So this is smaller than the other one. And even smaller than the smallest one. Okay, I have two different. I have another one in here. What is this? I have a kind of doily dice. That's nice. You know what? I'm gonna take the whole bag out. Let's see if I can. I'm gonna grab. Oh, this. I'm not sure. No, I'm not sure. So I do not dare to say what's inside. It's a bit heavy. Come on. Yes, I thought so. I couldn't feel the wooden handle, so I told myself better not say it's a stamp pad. But it is a stamp pad. So it's a stamp pad of a swan and one of... Harry Potter, the Hufflepuff one. That one is the one I couldn't, and this bag is empty. The Hufflepuff one is the one that I couldn't find for a long time, so that's why I finally found one. I have to say the story straight. I did find one, but the seller said I don't have it anymore. In stock, so I was not happy when he said that. I have another stamp head of the same the swan one, but this one is, what is this one again? I don't know what this one is. Is this the cat or a dog or a fox? I can't see. In any fall, it's an animal. Wait, I'm gonna take it out of the bag because there's such a glare. Ugh. The glare is terrible. So, can you see? I still can't see what kind of animal it is. There is a seller. He has a range of this stamp pad with an animal. I believe, two of those. But those you can say is season one, and this is season two stamps. These stamps has a range, but when I ordered this stamp, I'm going to show you why. This other seller had... I'm going to tell you the reason why, if I can. So this second seller, the other seller has, like I said, seller A has a wide range of animals playing the head lead, like this stamp. But the second seller, seller B, had only this stamp and other stamps that was about camping. And I thought to myself, I want all of these camping stamp heads, but I said to myself, it's not in within the reach within my budget. So I said to myself, only one camping stamp head. So I chose this one, and I thought to myself, it's silly if I order only just one. I thought to myself, well, seller B, I ordered just another one from the range, but then this only animal, he had only one animal, I believe. So I can order, this is seller B, so I can order with seller A the whole wide range. So now this is seller C. So he was, I believe, the one with the swan. And I was afraid that the swan will be like first to go. And I was in need of a swan because, like I said, Sonja Stegeman has a team that's about ballet, and the swan is also one of the ballet team. So I want to use that. And I had a metal die about swan. So that's why I ordered this one. And the seller had also the Hufflepuff stamp pad. So that's why I ordered for seller C, seller B, so I can finally order with seller A the whole wide range that I want, because those animals I don't have. I only have the cat version, and that cat version has like flowers on top like this. So it was a cat in the heat head role or a lead role, but then here are flowers. I had also another one with a cat, but it had stars above. So, and those were just season one, the only two cats that there was, and that's why in round two, I call it season two, it has more and other kind of animals in the lead part. So that's why I just wanted, that's why I wanted this, like I said, the swan. Shall I take it out of the bag? Oh no. Yeah, that's my boobies. I'm sorry. My boobies did that. Ugh. Sorry for that. I'm gonna take the Hufflepuff out. So now my Harry Potter, the crest, are complete. I have all of them, but not the others like Hogwarts 1, Hogwarts 2, Hogwarts 3, those things. I don't have those. I don't need those. So, as you can you see, this is the swan, and this is the other animal. I don't know what animal this is. I think it's a dog or a fox. I don't know. It's hard to see, but this is the most beautiful one I've ordered, the swan. So beautiful. One day I will show you all of them, but they are not the same. You can see here the side is flattened, but here it's not. It's not flattened. It looks like The stamp head looks like a bowl. It has a high rim. Can you see it? Wait. You see? It's the rim is a bit higher up. And that is not the case with this one. The rim is here flattened. So I need to see carefully the other one. The seller A that has the complete range of animals. I want to see how those stamps are, because these two are completely different. Okay, I guess I have opened all. Empty. Yes, I opened it all. So I have the stamp heads, the metal dies. I have the Maneko Neki, the smaller version and the somewhat bigger version. This is three different kinds of Maneko Neki. This is the same as the other one, but this is smaller and it is a bigger version of that. I have stickers, Star Wars stickers. And I have the metal dies of an umbrella and rain boots. The umbrella I have tried in the past. I'm talking about 2015, 2016, 2017. Each time I order the umbrella, every time the seller says, oh, I'm out of stock, I don't have them anymore. And it makes me so mad. So this time, finally, after so many years, I finally have an umbrella. So I'm really happy with those. I'm gonna clean this all up. So I'm gonna take out the loaded paper bag with the theme banana. Let's all go banana. So I'm gonna finish this up. I'm gonna put it aside. Clean everything up. I mean, the stamp heads need to be cleaned. So I'm gonna do that also. And then don't forget to make the washi tape samples for this. So I'm gonna do it in my own pace. But first I'm gonna clean up the stamp heads, the rubber ones, I mean. I'm sorry, it's not a stamp head, it's stamps. So I need to clean those up. And that's the end. So I don't want to call this part 5. This is going to be ridiculous. So I hope you enjoyed my real-time vlogging how to make a loaded paper bag themed bananas. So I hope you liked it. For the love of bananas, for the love of crafting, journaling and happy snail mail, I hope you enjoyed it today. And I'll see you next time. Bye everyone.